Can't do this alone.
Already dead.
Come here!
Use your tongue, or I will feed it to you!
Eivor! Versu Gengar!
Where did the others go?
This will make a fine space for my work, Eivor. Thank you.
Well, if your work benefits us, I will see that you keep it, for as long as you live among us.
I believe it will, for we have common cause against our enemy. They have dug their claws deep into England. Eradicate them where they are strongest, and the alliances you seek will be far easier to come by. In London, they now operate without restraint. If you were to eradicate them, the city would be in your debt.
I will talk with Ranri about your idea. Get her thoughts.
Good. Yet, before you do, there is something else. A gift I wish to share.
A gift?
I cannot show you here. Will you walk with me?
I will. Lead on. I hear heaviness to your breathing, Hytham. Does your wound still trouble you?
It does, I'm afraid. There is a pain in my chest for which I have no remedy.
Rest easy, then. So long as your mind stays sharp, you will recover.
Of course. Though I am reluctant to displease my mentor.
You would risk your health and your life to please Basim. That I do not understand.
I should not expect you to. When we first arrived, I noted a shadow of suspicion in your eyes. A doubt. A wariness.
Is that a question?
No. Only an observation.
Steer this boat.
I am. Have no worry. It is only prolonged stresses that exhaust me. My energy runs low rather quickly.
And what is this gift you wish to give me?
It will not come from me. It is a gift you must give yourself.
More riddles. What fun you are.
Let me say it another way. My gift is not for giving or taking. It is a way of living.
But still no clearer.
It is a thing better demonstrated than described.
Then I will wait.
Forgive my jest. This gift we call a leap of faith. It is one of our Brotherhood's most sacred rites. It is not a tool we use against our enemies, but an act we embrace to strengthen our resolve. Like your meditation, it centers our minds. Steadies our hands, and purges fear from our hearts. And more practically, it aids our movements, in flight or in stealth.
You call it a leap, and we are climbing a rather steep hill.
There it is again, the shadow of a doubt. Nearly there. Our destination is there.
I suspect you mean to throw me from this cliff, is that it? Please tell me if I'm near the mark.
And spoil the surprise? To perform the leap of faith, you must give yourself over to something greater.
The gods?
Yourself. Embrace the hope that death will not come before you are prepared to meet it. Believe this, and you will fear nothing.
Our deaths are prefigured, weaved into the fabric of the world. To fear this would be a waste of worry and tears.
Good. Then your mind is already attuned to my lesson. I will leap first. On my word, you must follow. Lean into your faith, into your strength, and take flight.
You want me to jump from here?
Yes.
I would sooner grow wings and fly away. Thank you for the lesson, but...
Wait! And watch!
Hytham! Hytham! Pig-headed fool! Are you injured?
You see? My faith grew stronger than my fear!
And that loam cushioned your fall.
Eivor! I have not seen this side of you before! Do not feed your fear! Conquer it!
I've seen my death in a vision. It was not here. Not today.
Yeah!
A perfect fall! And how did it feel?
You spoke true. It was madness and vigor, a purging of fear. A gift I give myself. I see that now. Thank you for showing me the way.
Of course. And thank you, Eivor, for hearing me out.
You called this leap of faith a sacred rite. Do all Hidden Ones practice this same ritual?
As far as I know, it is a rite of initiation that dates back to just before the birth of the Christian Jesus.
Are you hoping to initiate me?
I might try if I believed you would join. But that is not my purpose in England. Basim and I are hunting larger prey.
The Orb of Ancients.
Yes. You remember the medallion you took from Kjotve's body? That is their symbol. They are a plague, one we hope to purge from this world. Like us, they act in secret. But their aim is to rule the world, not free it from unnatural fetters.
The desire to rule is not unique to this order. Sigurd and I want the same, a land to call our own, and the honor that comes with it.
Do not compare yourself to such people. The Order has no honor, no principles, no humanity. Yet they sit on a great many of England's thrones. If you seek to pacify England for the safety of your clan...
Then it may be in my interest to give you aid. I understand.
You desire alliances. We seek to rid England of its deepening rot. Where these hopes meet, our cause does too. You may think this land ruled by harmless jarls and bumbling thanes, yet look more closely, and you will find a deeper threat. The Order's invisible hand touches all. It shapes everything, instilling its poison into every level of society. From the lowliest fishmonger to the richest merchants, from wealthy thanes to useless kings, the Order has corrupted all. Basim has given me one task here. To locate and eliminate the Order of Ancients in England, in whatever dark corners they reside. If we work together towards this end, it will benefit us both. You will have greater influence over the kingdoms of England.
And you will have more medallions to count.
Exactly. You should begin in London. I have credible reports that the Order is working now to seize the city.
I will speak with Randvi about this.
And while you are there, be on the lookout for our symbol. Centuries ago, the Hidden Ones had bureaus built around England. There were six, I believe. If you can find them, search them well for documents bearing the same symbol. It will greatly aid my studies.
I will. Thank you, Hytham, for all of this. Thank you.
right over there. Keep them out of your way when you aren't
using
them.
That is actually a very good idea.
Greetings.
We are allied with the Danes of Grandabritshire. Their Jarlskonna, Soma, has pledged an oath.
Well done, Eivor. These early victories will pay off well.
They will. In more than one way, one of Soma's finest fighters, Birna, has pledged her blade to us. She's a powerful fighter and a charming spirit. I think she'll fit in nicely.
Glad to have her. Good work.
At one time, the title Jarl referred to a man second... Oh, Jarl may be a chief, a leader, or a man with broad wealth and influence.
The world is bigger now, and broken into many pieces. It seems our language must do the same to keep up.
An interesting thought.
Chilbert, your father sent you here to learn, not teach.
Then you must start, Eivor. Give us a summary of our recent gains, for instance. The clan is thirsty for knowledge.
You want me to give a speech? Right. My friends, hearken to me, and hear a tale of triumph and toil. I have traveled far since we landed, and seen much on the roads and fields of this new England. And for all my travels, strong alliances have we gained. The honorable Ceolwulf, King of Mercia, now calls us friend. And to the south, Soma Jarlskonna and the Danes of Grandabritsch have pledged their oath to us. By Sigurd's hand and my own, we have strengthened the ties of...
You seat yourself as Sigurd's equal in these tales of yours. Would Sigurd do the same if he were here?
I do not claim to be Sigurd's equal, but I will not shy from the triumphs I have fairly won, Deg. Let glory seek and find those who have earned it. If that means me, so be it. If that means you, any of you, all the better. And so I raise my horn, first to Sigurd, may he return to us soon, and to the Raven Clan, the best of friends and fighters.
To Sigurd!
To Sigurd! May he return and relieve us of you!
And may all of you enjoy the ale as much as Dag has. Skål!
You think me drunk, Eivor? Would it soften my blows if I was?
Your words are blunt enough, but it would explain your boldness.
My eyes are clear and open, and I see before me one eager to claim a piece of Sigurd's glory.
All you say is nonsense, Dag. Have I done something to raise your ire?
Just as I thought. You're...
Attackers from the river! They look to be Danes!
Danes? How many?
Too many. Now come, the battle roars already.
Bloody curs! What quarrel have Danes with us?
All others stay here! With me!
Die!
No, you! The numbers are flagging! Press on!
You die! suffer!
Is that the last of them?
The rivers are clear. If more were coming, they thought better of it.
By their colors and markings, I believe they come from Geatland. Are there none left alive to spill their secrets? We may never know why.
Here is one! This vermin was crawling to the river, hoping to float away.
Have mercy, friend. And you may find an ally with us.
Mercy is earned by the quickness of your tongue. Where do you come from, and what is your quarrel with us?
We are settled in East Anglia. Newly arrived, and hungry for silver.
You drifted off course. This is Mercia.
As we were ordered.
By whom?
You bore me.
Useless hound! Scratching your ass in search of silver! Put an end to this one!
Your silence earned you no kindness, Geet. So I'll ask you once more. Who sent you?
The wind sent us. And the rivers will take us home.
He begs for death, Eivor! Give it to him!
Or send him home with a warning. Let him tell his people what death awaits them, should they sail this way again.
May there be one who mourns you at home, for we will not.
Eivor, I could have sent my scouts to follow him home. We might have learned something.
The price of such disrespect is death, Randvi.
Just as Sigurd would have done.
I cannot devise a strategy if my advice is ignored.
To let that man live would announce to the world that we are soft and cowardly. Now these wayward Danes know to fear us.
Forgive my haste, Randvi, but Dag is right.
For once you see clearly. I beg the gods that it continues.
We should clean this mess and move the bodies from the camp.
Agreed. Then we talk of our next steps, together.
Message has come.
You look well.
I want to see the Alliance map. Those Dane invaders. They came from East Anglia, is that right?
Yes. Dane invaders who serve a man called Ruard. He seems to be sowing discord among Saxons and friendly Danes alike. Years ago, the sons of Ragnar hoped to pacify the land. They appointed a steward named Finnir to find a suitable Saxon king. But the kingdom has fallen into ruins since, with no king and violent raiders ravaging what little peace remains. I suggest you make for East Anglia and find out what their steward is doing wrong.
I will make the trip east then. Speak to this Finnir myself.
A good plan.
Eivor, have you seen Wallace?
Eivor, takk fyrir síðast!
Those invaders never stood a chance. Not when you are armed with Gunnar's handiwork.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
You have a keen eye for quality. I can get you that one easy. That's pretty good. Ready for battle.
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
May this sing of your deeds and my craftsmanship.
Oh. Eivor. You should hear this.
This Bakrat and his friends had the foolish balls to raid Ravensthorpe.
Are the others dead?
A few. Most of them escaped. They did not damage much, but made off with some of our gear. Should I get Ranvi?
No. She has enough on her table. I will handle this. So, you thought you would play at Vikinga, little man. Are you prepared to go all the way?
You won't get anything out of me, Danish scum. I'll never talk.
I'm Norse. And what makes you think I want to hear you talk? Maybe I will take my payment in flesh. Chop off his leg. It does not have to be a clean cut. No need to sharpen your blade.
No, please! Don't cut off my leg! It was Sir Edward who wanted your stuff! He paid us to do it!
Sir Edward?
Yes, the Earl of Westerna! Or that's what he calls himself. Said he hates Vikings, your lot especially.
Where can I find this Sir Edward, Earl of Westerna?
I don't know, I'm new! We were supposed to steal the gear, then meet at the longship west of Ravensburg. That's all I know!
You can take him to Randri now. Maybe we can trade him for a pig. I am off to check out this longship.